can't stand this blimp. This quarantine has stopped me from going to the dentist.
And it stopped me from going to the liquor store. What, am I not allowed to go there?
You're like 12. Besides, this town has a liquor store. Alcohol is horrible for your body. Nobody should drink it.
This has been a public service announcement.
Oh, it does? I won't ever go there again.
Dude, the public service announcement is over.
Oh, sorry, I guess I just got caught in the moment.
Idiot!
So what are you doing with those BB guns?
Dude, I'm gonna take care of this blimp.
Is that Surgeon General Fink? It is. You're an evil man, and in movies, evil always loses.
But this isn't the movies. This is a short film.
I'm gonna fail my hydration test for wrestling!
We have just received word that the blimp Surgeon General Fink was controlling has crashed with no help from the military. Believe it or not, a young boy with a BB gun had shot it down. At the scene of the blimp wreckage, investigators have not found Fink, but they did find Dr. Isaac Padilla, a scientist who we've had on our show many times to inform us about the attacks. He had a syringe of malaria stuck in his arm, and we assume that Surgeon General Fink had stuck it in there. Luckily, he was vaccinated for malaria a number of years ago, and he should be fine. Unfortunately, Fink has escaped, and he is hiding somewhere inside KBville. We urge anybody to find him, and if you turn him in to the police or authorities, we will reward you with $5 million. I don't know about you, but I'm starting my search right now. That's a wrap. I'm out of here. We'll be right back.
Get out of my living room.
Why don't you just let me live here? I promise not to attack you when I'm getting revenge on the city.
What's your emergency?
Well, I just found Surgeon General Fink in my home. I knocked him out and now he's unconscious and waiting to be put in jail. I was wondering when I'd get my $5 million. Oh, it'll be another month? If I wanted to have a yacht by Friday. Oh, you need to collect the money first. Okay, could you give me $350,000 for now and pay the rest later? Because that's how much the yacht cost. Duh. Oh, the cops are here now. Well, I guess I'll call you sometime. What? Only calls for an emergencies? What is this crap? A true emergency is when I have nobody to talk to.
Hello, Surgeon General Fink. You probably already know me. I'm Merrillson, and I brought Austin Blagman from the news station so your confessions would go to the media. And Dr. Isaac Padilla, whom I'm sure you already know. Now, were you or were you not the man controlling the blimp above KBville?
Of course he was! His face was on the blimp!
Well, maybe someone did it to draw attention to someone else.
Either way, he's going to jail for attacking me.
You bring up a good point. So, Surgeon General Fink, were you?
I have the right to remain silent, don't I?
Would any truly innocent person say that when asked that question?
You bring up a good point. Then I guess I didn't.
You guess you didn't? How could you not know?
Well, sometimes I sleepwalk and, well, I do crazy things when I sleepwalk. Like once I woke up with all my body bruised and I was inside a vending machine in a bowling alley. Bad memories.
For that to be true, you'd have to be asleep for 3 days straight.
Well, I had a lot of cappuccinos a week ago and I was away for 4 days straight. I needed my sleep badly.
You can still be arrested for things that you did while sleepwalking.
Okay, fine, I made it up. Are you happy?
That's all we needed. Now that you've confessed, you're going to jail no matter what. So why don't you just confess why you did it?
I already told Mayor Olson that. And at the time, it was because I thought I wouldn't be caught.
Well, I've got to get going. I've got to check up on the malaria injection you gave me. Have fun in jail.
I'll have a blast.
Wow, I must be some sort of escape artist. I'm like Houdini.
No, Fink Dini. Yeah, I'll change my name once I get to Cuba where they can't arrest me. Then I'll make money on the streets by escaping from sketchy scenarios.
I heard Career playing. He can't be far.
Shoot, I gotta think fast.
He threw this bottle at us. It must be filled with some sort of disease. Let's give him a taste of his own medicine.
Huh, I guess they fell into my trap. Wait, why isn't it open? I guess they must have shut it after the diseases came out. I better refill this thing.
Problem solved.
And that's how we put Fink in jail. Now, our team of researchers has just discovered that there was a very similar incident that happened in the subway systems of Tokyo. A team of men had placed packages that released a gas called sarin in the subway systems. The symptoms of being exposed to sarin are tightness of the chest, constriction of the pupils, nausea, drooling, as well as uncontrollable vomiting, urination, and defecation, which will be followed by uncontrollable twitching. Eventually, victims go into a coma and suffocate during spasms. Sarin is known to be 500 times more lethal than cyanide, which is obviously extremely lethal. And it is officially listed as a weapon of mass destruction. Over 5,000 people in the 1995 attack were affected by the sarin. Most of the men who initiated the attack were sentenced to death. We can be thankful that Surgeon General Fink did not use sarin on us. However, he did use a less lethal disease on a much larger scale. Will Fink be sentenced to death? Nobody thinks so. Making him live with only his thoughts for the rest of his life seems like the biggest punishment. Even the Unabomber wasn't sentenced to death. So why should he?
So our proud city is now safe, once and for all. Let's keep it this way. Be safe. Thank you. Hello?
Hello, Mr. Olson. This is the warden of Kbeville County Prison. I have some bad news.
What is it?
Fink escaped.
And now I will escape from this straitjacket.
Yeah.
I can't get out. Somebody help me! Cut it off of me, please!